Hello friends, in this session I will discuss the structure of the neuron. So in that neuron, what are the parts are there? So first of all, cell body, it will be that we are calling in this area the cell body. And second part is dendrites, all these hair like projections, whatever we have been observing in the anterior portion of the neuron, that will be the dendrites. We have been observing dendrites, hair-like projections. So next, third part is axon. So here that hair-like projection towards the posterior area, the axon we are calling. So here what are the other things we have been observing in the neuron is in the cell body area, Nessel's granules also there. You see that type of areas, Nessel's granules, another name, and glandular bodies. The Nessel granules we have been observing in the cell body area, and hair-like projections of dendrites here, that from here to here up to axon we are calling. So in this area, axon terminal area branches are there, hair-like projections here also look like that. Axon terminal branches are there, the small branches, it has been splitted. So up to here the single axon is there. Afterwards, whenever it will be reached to that terminal part of the axon, so that will be look like a branched. So that's why in this edge portion area, the synaptic knob we are calling, synaptic knob in this area, so many more synaptic knobs are there. So in that area, synoptic vessels are there in that area. That synaptic vessels having the neurotransmitters. The neurotransmitter main purpose here is neuron to neuron. Some gap is there. That neurotransmitter will be transmitting the signals. So that topic will become upcoming session. So here that neurotransmitters in this area, whatever absorbing the signals. So from which area to which area transmitting the signals? From the dendrites area. All the dendrites area transmitting the signals through the cell body, and then through the axon area towards the axon terminal area it has been reached, and finally synoptic knob area it has been reached. Upwards, here the gap is there. You just imagine it, here one neuron is there, one more neuron will be attaching here the dendrites portions of the areas in the each synoptic knob areas. But neuron to neurons, a slight gap might be there. At the time, transmitting of the signal is somewhat difficult to transfer because of the due to synoptic cleft we are calling. So due to overcome the problems, whatever the problem, that gap area, that neurotransmitters will be helpful to transmit. It will be acting as a mediators from the neuron to one neuron of the axon terminal synoptic knob to the further whatever the beside of that in this area particular another neuron of the dendrites area. So it will be helpful, it is acting as a mediators. But here always the dendrites, hair-like projections, whatever we have been observing in the anterior portion of the neuron, that will be observing the signals, transmitting signals, whatever the electric signals from the before of the synoptic knob of the another neuron. So like that, so that will be transmitting like this. And here you see that here in the axon portion, outer side area, squam cells are there. So afterwards, myelinated sheath we have been observing. And the myelin sheath in this area, some boxes like we have been observing outside area of that whatever the axon. So here this will be node of Ranvier we are calling. Here you see that node of Ranvier we have been observing. So that next, that will be small gap type. So each and every squam cells having the nucleus that will be maintaining in that particular area whatever requirement is there, all these things, so that will be focusing that whatever present in that squam cell area. And here the transmitting the electric signal, generating whatever electric signals that will be calling action potential. That will be action potential we are calling. And here the cell body areas, after absorbing the signal, it has been transferring through and reached to synaptic knob area. So here surrounding of the neuron area, what are the cells are there, supporting cells, surrounding of the neurons area, each and every neuron area in the cell. What are those cells we have been observing? Glial cells. What is the main purpose of that? Housekeeping, to maintain clean and other things, whatever. So that glial cells we have been calling, and astrocytes also, that will be surrounding of the neuron area. We have been observing that will be nutritional support purpose, whatever required for nutrition related to surviving purpose, that astrocytes will be supplying to the neuron, the nutritional support it will be giving. And microglia, the phagocytic function, engulfment of the any foreign particles and other things, it will be performing without affecting the neuron. So the microglia are playing major role as acting as a phagocytic function. And next year, in this central portion area of the cell body, nucleus is there, that will be having DNA, deoxynucleic acid, as well as the ribonucleic acid also there. This will be main purpose is growth and reproduction purpose. So growth and reproduction purpose. One more important point regarding the neuron here is, the neuron lacks centrioles. It does not have any centrioles, the neurons. So that's why there is no mitosis. We have not been observing the mitosis. There is no mitosis because of due to the lack of centrioles. Centrioles playing a major role in the mitosis process. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, whatever phases are there in the cell cycle. So that will be, there is no mitosis because of the lack of the centrioles in the neurons. So that's, there is no dividing of the neurons. Can't divide. And but this neuron will be helpful to transmit the signals very quickly, coordinating purpose. Very quickly coordinating, and one neuron to another neuron, and one place to another place, the transmitting the signals in the nervous system, the neurons playing a major role. So that's why neuron is the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. It will be transmitting very, very fast. And here the signal transmitting time also based upon the myelinated sheet. Generally the myelinated sheet neurons transmitting more fast if compared with the whatever the unmyelinated sheets. So generally the myelinated sheets neurons we have been observing, and the spinal cord and the cranial nerves area. These are the very tight junctional area, just like a highway type. So that's why we need very fast transmitting of the signal. So that's why, so that will be the myelinated sheet neurons also. So whatever that surrounding of the axon as well as the squamous cells also there. And this will be having the myelinated sheet neurons generally in the spinal and cranial nerves area. So it has been wrapped around whatever that axon is there. So that area that will be attaching. So the myelinated sheet in this area. So in the unmyelinated sheet area, nerve fibers with squamous cells also there, but not form myelinated sheet around the axon. Around the axon, it has not been around the axon, but here around the axon not form the myelinated sheet. So that will be we are observing in the autonomous and somatic neural system area. If compared with this myelinated, it will be a little bit less rush that transmitting signals. So the spinal and the cranial nerves area, the spinal area, especially the cranial nerves area, more importance. And if compared with the central nervous system area, whatever the brain area, if compared with that, the autonomous and the somatic neural systems a little bit less signals as well as that pressure. So that's why the unmyelinated sheet neuron generally we have been observing autonomous as well as the somatic neural system area. And here, and a few more important points here I would like to share you. Here, types of neurons. So what are the types of neurons? On number of axon and dendrite base. How many, whatever the axons are there, how many dendrites are there, based upon that types of neurons we have been observing. So what are those? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 types. Multipolar, bipolar, unipolar, pseudo-unipolar neurons. So what is the multipolar? Multi within the name answer is there. One axon and 2 to 3 dendrites. Minimum 2 to 3 dendrites we have been observing in the multipolar. That's why multi, more than 2 minimum. So the one axon plus 2 to 3 dendrites. So that will be, we are observing in the cerebral cortex area, main junctional area, main brain areas also very, very neurons, many more neurons, more approximately 10 billion neurons have been observing approximately. There is no exact number also till date because of that much of very stressable manner that will be neurons present in the brain area, and approximate numbers we have been considering. So here the cerebral cortex area, that multipolar neurons we have been observing. Next, bipolar neurons means one axon, one dendrite. So one axon is there, only one dendrite. There is no any multidendrites like this. So only one axon, one dendrite we have been observing the retina of eye area. Such kind of bipolar neurons we have been observing. So based upon the necessity, whether it is fully trophic zone area, whether it is lesser, based upon that situation, necessity of the function, the arrangement of the neurons have been present in the body due to the evolutionary changes also playing a major role. And like that, it has been taking place millions of the years to develop a well-developed mammals, so that is human beings, from the invertebrates to vertebrates. So whatever I told in the previous sessions, that invertebrates like protozoa, porifera, then cylindrate and nidarius, platelminthes, nematelminthes, and later arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, then hemichordata, then in that chordata area, pisces, amphibians, reptiles, apes, mammals. Like that, mammals are the highest developed organs in the vertebrate category area on the earth also. So that's this much of complicated neurons and nervous system have been took place for many more millions of years, the human being origin as per the evolutionary evidences. So that's why, so here the bipolar neurons written on the eye we have been observed. And unipolar neurons, only cell body is there, there is no any dendrites, only cell body we have been observing. And one axon in the embryonic stage, still development might be required. So that is in the embryonic stage type, the cell body only there. There is no proper development of the dendrites in the unipolar neurons area. So that's why cell body and one axon only we have been observing in the embryonic stages, that unipolar neurons. And the fourth one, pseudo unipolar, not much of development. One axon is there and cell body branching like dendrites. Cell body also not properly developed. So that's why pseudo, we are calling pseudo unipolar. So cell body also branching like hairs, still they need to develop the cell body in this case of pseudo unipolars. And we are observing in the dorsal root ganglion of the spinal cord areas. That will be in the dorsal root ganglion of spinal cord area, pseudo unipolars we have been observing. So like that, the neuron playing a major role to transmit the signals, the electrical signals, and that will be falling towards the axon potential, and this will be transmitting the signal from the dendrites towards the axons area and finally reach to synaptic nerve area, and the neurotransmitter playing major role to accept the whatever the electrical signal and axon potential, and whatever the message in the form of granules, it will be splitting, and further neuron of the dendrites it has been receiving, and like that signals have been transferring from one area to another area very quickly and coordinating manner. That signals will be transmitting, and based upon that the functional system of the nervous system working properly. So thank you very much.